What will be the coverage of this session, right? First, I'll decipher the prelims syllabus. Then, we will see the last 5 years pattern of the UPSC. The questions that UPSC is asking in the last 5 years, right? Then we will see the 2021 pattern, the last prelims pattern, right? Then we will discuss why economy is difficult for most of the people, if not everyone, right? Even it is not about difficult, but it is one of the challenging subject. It is never ending subject, right? Then we will discuss the step by step approach that we should follow. In this, we will follow the different type of questions, the different categories of questions which are asked, and then we will see the pitfalls and the traps in which the aspirants fall, right? Then we will see how we can solve the MCQs of the economy, right? The different tricks to solve the MCQs, different things to be taken care while solving the MCQs of the economy, right? Then how to cover the economy for the mains examination. So how to cover the economy for the mains examination, we shall cover that. And in the last, I'll share the details of the course. So this is the coverage that we are going to have, and I am promising you will get a lot more clarity about economy, right? And you will get the exact approach how to prepare for the Indian economy, okay? So if we see the syllabus, right? The session of today is primarily focused on the prelims. Today I'll be primarily focusing on the prelims part, not upon the mains. For mains, we can have a separate session, or I'll give a very small overview how to cover the economy for the mains examination, right? The first thing is about the prelims, and I'll be focusing more upon that, right? So what is the syllabus of the economy for the prelims? If we see the syllabus, these are the words given in the syllabus. So the syllabus is indicative. This syllabus, if we see, it is not saying money and banking, it is not saying external sector, it is basically saying economic and social development, SD, poverty, inclusion, demographics, social sector initiatives. Now if you see the questions in the previous year, the questions are coming from the money and banking, foreign sector, national income, but those of things have not been given here, right? So this syllabus is just indicative, and this syllabus can't help us to decide what to read, what not to read, okay? So what is the best way out then? How to go about it? फिर क्या करना चाहिए? किससे पूछें कि क्या करना है? After the syllabus, the second best source is previous year questions. Very good. So previous year question is the best guide to decide the type of questions which are being given and the areas which are being asked. Okay. So we have to do the previous year question analysis to decipher what type of questions they are asking. Right. So for those people who are repeating the prelims examination again and again, in starting you might feel that I am telling you very basic things, but after 10-15 minutes you will get to know. I'll be deepening the discussion. I'll be getting deep into the discussion, right? And for beginners, you should not worry. If you are a beginner, I'll take care of you, okay? So this is about the syllabus. Now coming to the next part, what are the components of the syllabus? If we analyze the previous year questions, the first area which is important, from which the questions can come, even if the questions don't come, but you should understand the first topic, that is the basics. For example, what is economic growth, difference between growth and development, national income, GDP, different methods of national income, then inflation is very, very, very important topic. Because if you want to understand the current affairs, then you should also understand the inflation, right? Inflation, almost every week you will find one news, CPI is going down, up, WPI, state government doing this, central government doing this, right? Second is money and banking. If I say in one word, at least 30% to 40% questions of the economy will be coming from money and banking. So every year 5 to 6 questions average, they come from this area, right? We will further deepen this discussion. Budget, taxation and fiscal sector, the public financing, deficits, you know, taxation, different kind of developments. So this is another big area. Then we have foreign sector, which includes current account deficit, exports, imports, all of this, right? So this is another area which is under focus. Now these five chapters, they are the core, and if you cover these, 80% of the prelims is done. So in the prelims masterclass, I emphasized on one thing, that you should not go through the syllabus in the academic approach, like from A to Z I will read everything. You should read everything, but the topic which are really important, cover them multiple times. So these four areas, they will be giving you 80% questions. And if you see the number of marks, in the number of marks, they'll be giving at least 20 marks questions every year. 20 marks is a very big, like if you see the cutoff is around 100 marks or maximum 110. So 20 marks is very, very good contribution. So these four chapters, master them, each and every concept, right? Other chapters, for example, we have agriculture. Yes, agriculture, industry services, they are simpler, and nowadays they are also becoming important, especially the agriculture area, because agriculture is overlapping with environment, it is overlapping with the geography, it is overlapping with the government schemes. So agriculture is an area which is also becoming important, but mostly the questions are non-economic questions from the agriculture. So you should not confuse agriculture economy. Agricultural economy is not that much important. Okay. Then next is infrastructure. Infrastructure, yeah, maybe some current affairs will come from the infrastructure. Then we have social sector, for example, poverty, unemployment. Okay. Now, if you want to ask me, sir, what is the syllabus of GS Mains? Primarily, these areas, which include agriculture, industry and services, infrastructure and social sector, these are the focus area of the mains examination, right? So mains may, they're asking primarily these four areas. They are giving the details of the main syllabus in the GS Mains. For example, agriculture, they are further deepening into land reforms, then you know, e-technology, then your agricultural financing, then your food processing, agricultural marketing. So entire value chain of the agriculture they are covering. Industry also, they are covering, you know, MSME, they are covering industrial revolution, they are covering ease of doing business, right? In the services, the banking sector, infrastructure, like every area of the infrastructure, transport, energy, inside the energy also, you know, every kind of energy, coal energy, oil and gas, and every area. Then inside the transport also, railway, you know, ships, road, every area, right? So they are deepening this. Social sector, like inclusive growth, poverty, unemployment, jobless growth. If you see, 90% of the syllabus of the GS paper 3, the economy and agriculture portion, this is nothing but these three areas. Are you getting a hint? So 80% questions coming from these four chapters, and 20% questions of the prelims coming from these three chapters, and 80% of the questions coming in the mains examination from these three chapters, 20% questions coming from initial 30. Are you getting an idea how to simplify the syllabus of GS mains and prelims economy portion? So starting ke jo this 1, 2, 3, 4, prelims focused, 5, 6, 7, mains focused. Yeah, there is an overlap. We should always cover the syllabus of mains examination if we want to get good marks in the prelims. That is why I always say, please complete the syllabus of GS2 and GS3 before the prelims. Because this area, you will be deepening in the mains examination only. They can ask APMC, certain features of APMC. APMC, you might skip in the prelims, because in the prelims, the focus is on other areas. But if you cover the APMC in the mains examination, it will be easier for you to cover the question, right? Clear? Now, are you clear about this syllabus division between the prelims and mains? So you should accordingly, you know, focus, because this division is very, very elusive. Everything that comes in our front, you know, we think ki isko bhi cover karna hai. But unless and until we prioritize the topic every time, then, you know, we can't really do justice to the effort, right? Now, certain other dimensions of the syllabus, how to decipher the syllabus. The syllabus we can divide into micro and macro economy. So what is the difference between two?
Micro means individual level.
Individual level. Micro means at the very micro level, individual decisions, demand, supply and all. And macro means at the
broader
level, national level, state level, aggregate level, basically, right? So if you see, which area is the syllabus of UPSC out of these two?
Macro.
So you can say 99.99% questions are coming from there. Yes, 0.01% questions will be coming from the micro. So on occasional basis, they will ask, suppose this in 21, they asked a question about substitute goods, inferior goods, right? Complementary goods. So this was the question from the micro. Then a couple of years back, they asked the question about opportunity cost. What is the meaning of opportunity cost? So on and off, maybe in, you know, couple of years, they ask one question. There is one book of microeconomy, 12th class. So at the most, what you can do, you can read this book, the important words of this book, and your microeconomy is done. No need to do the further research. At the most, what you can do apart from this is, you can cover the previous questions of other UPSC examinations, for example CDS. So because in those examinations sometimes they ask the questions of the microeconomy, so those type of questions they can ask here. Are you getting? So microeconomy, only two resources you can follow. Number one, the 12th class microeconomy book. Now please do not read that book page to page, word to word. Only the important areas you have to do. Okay. So if you need, then maybe I can make a list of the topic that you can cover from there. From the index, I can mark and I can post on the Telegram channel. So that is one thing I can do. And secondly, the previous year questions of the other UPSC examinations, the CDS, like for example, और कौन सा एग्जाम होता है आपका?
Others like
CRPF, हाँ,
इंजीनियरिंग सर्विसेज
हो गया. तो वहाँ पे जो क्वेश्चंस आते हैं, they can ask certain questions of microeconomy from there. So I think that compilation also I can provide to you, but it will take some time. Okay, so these are the two homework from me. ठीक है, आपको भी मैं होमवर्क दूंगा. So these are the two homework assignments for me. I will be completing after this class, right? So this is how you have to cover the microeconomy. Do not go beyond these two things, right? Macroeconomy, I'll be telling you in detail how to go about it, right? Second thing is static and current. Big interlinkage is there, right? Really, it is very difficult to decide, you know, almost everything that they're asking in the current affairs is the conceptual, based upon the static portion. So whenever you are reading the current affairs, please keep the book aside, whichever book you are having, right? And always revise your stuff directly. Suppose there is a question about inflation. I mean, there is a news about the inflation. So you open the book of whichever notes you are following, and go and read the basic concept. So, you know, what is more important is the concept. What is less important is the news. So news you should follow only for the purpose of deciding the importance of the topic. Go back and cover the topic of inflation in depth. Okay, the questions that might come, the questions that have already come in the previous question, you should focus upon that. So always follow the current affairs only for the purpose of reference. Mostly they don't ask direct questions from the current, because in the current there is a news ki CPI bada ki ghata, but what are the factors? What is the factors behind inflation? What are the factors? And if there is a drastic change, there is a big drastic change by the government, like base year change kar diya, so wo type ke jo questions, wo type ke jo areas hain, wo aapko majorly cover karne hote hain. Otherwise simple news you can ignore. Okay
sir,
data I'll be coming, data ke liye I'll be coming. Okay, I understand. Data is your pain point.
Current is
theory and application part. Okay. Again, application part is more focused nowadays. Okay. They will give 3-4 statement and they will ask a particular question. Right. So whenever you are reading, see, in totality, in the economy, you know, economy ke liye jo log ka process clear hota hai, the people who are very very logical, for them economy is very easy. So maybe engineers or other logical people, mathematics wale log bhi economy mein easy feel karte hain. But still people are facing difficulty. And for you, what I will be suggesting is there are hardly how many concepts, you know, 50 concepts in UPSC. Prelims economy. 50 concepts mein, can you give some example? Which are really, really, I mean, the core of economy. And if you get, understand those, then your economy is done. Baki to aapka bahut simple area hai. Jaise ki
exchange rates.
Yeah, exchange rate, how they are decided and their movement upward hoga to kya hoga. Uske causes kya hai, impact kya hai. I mean, understand the real life. Okay. Yeah, monetary policy. Monetary policy may be specifically go into the details like repo rate, reverse repo rate. I mean, what I say is most of the people will make mistake here only. And these are the questions which are repetitively asked. So mark those 50 concepts, okay? Or again, this can be homework for me. Right, so I'm getting more clarity about what should be my homework after this class, right? So maybe I can provide you the list of those questions. I always discuss, but maybe for the purpose of prioritization, I can provide the list of the topic which you should really understand with the help of the previous question, with the help of more MCQ practice, and with the help of the current affairs. I mean, you should master, okay? So in the mains maximizer master class and the mains, I always categorize the topic into A, B and C. Those people who have attended the mains maximizer master class, I always tell them category A topic you should cover in the 360 degree manner. Similarly here, these 50 concepts you should cover in the 360 degree manner. Similarly in the other topic also, other subjects, for example in the polity, in geography, there are every subject is having maximum 50 concepts which are troubling for most of the people, and they don't resolve those doubts and they are always lingering. Jab bhi question aayega in exchange rate pe wo phas jayenge. Devaluation aur revaluation mein farak isme nahi aata. Depreciation appreciation mein atak jate hain ja karke. Right? So for these type of question you should understand. If you are not able to understand, then cram kar lijiye. Theek hai? In previous master class I shared a concept of revision register, you know. Revision register bataya tha maine aapko. So when you are preparing the revision register, always include these concept there. Ki suppose exchange rate hai. So factors which will increase exchange rate, factors which will decrease exchange rate. Okay. And now, you know, what is the difference between exchange rate and the value of the domestic currency? Means jo bhi confusing areas hai na, pehle aap usi pe focus kijiye. Usme clarity leke aaiye. Are you getting? Making sense? Bulb or moment, BOM. So if you learn something new, we have a culture in our classes, BOM, bulb on moment, right? So is it a bulb on moment for you? Okay, so those 50 concepts, please list down and, you know, get a clarity over them. And the best way will be teach someone else. Usko padha dijiye, kisi aur ko. So you will be getting the 100% clarity. Now coming to the previous 5-year questions topics, the analysis of last 5-year topics. So in last, in fact, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 years ho gaya. Theek hai. So can see money and banking repetitively, except in 1 year, they're asking, you know, 5 questions, 6 questions, 5 questions, 6 questions. Last 4 years mein toh, average is more than 5 questions, right? Then in the basic, they can ask 1 question, they can ask 4 questions as well. Basic toh bahut achha hona chahiye. Fiscal policy taxation, average 2 questions. If you take, it will be average 2 questions. External sector, average 2 to 3 questions. Government schemes are another big area. This year it was not much focused, but a big area. Other areas like population, Indian agriculture. Agriculture maybe there is a big overlapping. So If I say, you know, 6 questions, it includes the questions of environment and geography also, right? But specifically about the economy, 2 questions will be there. Planning, on and off, 1 question. Industrial policy, on and off, 1 question. Financial markets, yes, this is another area. They can ask the questions in the same time because stock market is the news. Upward movement ho raha hai, new kind of financial instruments are coming, bonds, then your ETFs. So new kind of instruments are coming, that is why they are asking this financial market topic on and off in the recent time. Inflation, yeah, this is a area on and off they keep asking. This year they have asked 2 questions. So inflation, anyways, you have to understand. Clarity, so this is what you have to understand, that there are few topics which are really very very important. Now pattern of UPSC 2021, okay. So 2021 questions were mostly conceptual. If you are good at concept, you can easily practice the, you can easily get the answer, okay. And they have been asking the practical implications mostly, like about the money multiplier, about the demand pull inflation, right? So application part, suppose there is a news about you know, monetary policy, please go and revise all the concept of monetary policy. This should be the approach. Rather than reading the unnecessary news, go back and revise your basics. Then in 2021, as I already discussed, they have briefly touched the 2021 the microeconomy. They have briefly touched this area. Like they have asked this question. Demand, okay, substitute, complement, inferior goods. This is microeconomy, right? Now, why economy is difficult? Tell me. Why economy seems difficult for you?
Because basic concepts are like repo rate, reverse repo rate are always confusing.
Basic concepts are
always
confusing, okay?
Another thing is about data.
Data, okay.
Do we need to statistics and all that?
Okay. So basic concepts confusing hote hain.
Especially banking part.
Especially banking part. Wahin pe hai zyadatar. And then we have data. डेटा को कैसे याद करें, फैक्ट्स को कैसे याद करें, कैसे उसको अंडरस्टैंड करें. ओके, न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट में आप प्रॉब्लम होती है आपको. ओके, नो माय क्वेश्चन इज, यू नो व्हाई इट इज डिफिकल्ट, व्हाई इट इज नेवर एंडिंग.
थिंग इज सर दैट देयर इज ऑलवेज फियर ऑफ व्हाट इज अ न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट, बिकॉज़ वंस यू आर नॉट क्लियर अबाउट बेसिस, देयर इज ऑलवेज फियर ऑफ अनएक्सप्लोर्ड थिंग्स दैट व्हाट माइट कम अप, व्हाट माइट, हाउ टू कोरिलेट. We are not able to get the link.
Due to paper pressure, basics become difficult. Paper ka pressure, performance pressure basically. Exam day fear. Okay. So I have worked with so many people. First of all, before preparation of UPSC, most of the people, they never read economy. Except in case you are going through the BA course in economy, or you are the graduate in commerce. I mean, yeah, or you are having the commerce and accountancy in your 11th, 12th. Most of the people, they never read economy before the UPSC. So this is one reason why there is always a phobia of the economy, right? Phobia, what is the meaning of phobia?
Yeah.
Irrational fear. Irrational fear, okay? So it's not a real fear. Secondly, there is not a single book which covers economy fully. This is another problem. Now you will say, sir, Ramesh Singh outdated. Okay, many concepts are not relevant. I mean, they have given things which are not going to help, and it is too bulky. If you ask me, the videos of a famous teacher, I will not name. They are, and you know, they are focusing on multiple examinations because of their commercial interest. So they are. If you want to prepare for all the examinations, then you can see the videos and, you know, read the thousand pages of that material of economy. You will not become the master of economy. You will become something else. You will always struggle in the basic concept because they are covering useless things. So the problem is that even the courses which are there in the market, only few courses are there which are only and only focusing on the UPSC. Most of the books and the so-called famous teachers, they are focusing on all examinations to increase their reach, and in the process they lose the UPSC focus. Are you getting? So they lose the UPSC focus, right? So you are here for UPSC preparation. You can go for another preparation if you don't clear the UPSC, but if you start preparing for all the examinations from day one, then you will never clear the UPSC, right? Because you have already decided that I will not clear the UPSC, right? Second, next thing is dynamic nature. Almost every day you will find one news of the economy. कुछ मिले ना मिले, पार्लियामेंट बंद रहेगी तो पॉलिटिकल न्यूज आनी बंद हो जाएंगी, लेकिन इकोनॉमी तो डेली चलेगी, राइट? अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट के बारे में न्यूज होगा, गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स के बारे में न्यूज होगा, राइट? देन डिफिकल्ट टू डिफाइन बाउंड्रीज, राइट? सो ऑल द इकोनॉमी टीचर दे विल से 25 क्वेश्चंस है इकोनॉमी से, आइए हमारा कोर्स ज्वाइन कीजिए, राइट? सो वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू डिफाइन द बाउंड्रीज. सेम क्वेश्चन, इट माइट हैव वन स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द इकोनॉमी, वन स्टेटमेंट ऑफ द ज्योग्राफी, one statement of the science and technology also, right? So this is one thing. I mean, government scheme also we are including in economy. Actually government scheme are not part of the economy, they are part of the governance. So government scheme in MG Narega, what is the concept of economy? MG Narega is MG Narega. There are some features, there are some inclusions, there are some exclusions. So why should I teach you MG Narega in the economy class? I should focus on the concept part, na? So you know, trying to cover everything, you should cover everything, but you know, you have to define, you know, these are the five topics which is the core economy of the UPSC prelims: money and banking, external sector, public finance and taxation, national income, inflation, financial markets. Six chapters is the core of UPSC prelims economy. I'm repeating, if you want to write basics, national income, etc. Inflation. Third is financial markets, money and banking, public finance, taxation, fiscal sector, and then we have external sector. Six topics आपके जो core हैं, 90% questions आपके यहाँ से बनेंगे. बाकी peripheral areas हैं, poverty, unemployment, infrastructure, industry, you know, agriculture. Those are the peripheral areas. So you should focus on these six areas and you will become the master of economy. Your questions in economy will not go wrong, right? Now, what is a step-by-step approach for economy? And for that matter, this approach you can follow for any subject, right? First, glance the previous year questions. Very, very important. So if you buy the previous year question bank, buy only that bank which is having the topic wise listing, okay? Second, build the foundation, basic concept which I told you, 50 concept from 6 chapters. Right? 50 concepts, 6 chapters. Application of concept. So whenever you are going through the current affairs, apply. Try to think the application part, right? Revision, very, very important. Okay. And then finally, MCQ and PYQ practice. This will test your exam reality, right? So don't become intellectual, otherwise you have to convert your optional into economics optional, right? So always be exam oriented. Define your boundaries for this preparation, right? Now, starting with the previous year questions, the different type of questions which are coming, let us see the different categories of questions which are appearing in the previous year, okay? So in the previous year, the first category of questions is the conceptual questions. These conceptual questions, they can be definition based questions. For example, gold trench, I'll tell you, okay, what is the meaning of gold trench, reserve gold trench, okay? Then it can be based upon some process, some interlinkage. I will show you the different questions on this. The second category of questions is from the data and facts. So those people who fear the data and facts, don't worry, I'll come and we'll discuss, right? Next category of questions is from the government schemes, right? Next category of questions is from the organizations. These organizations can be national or international. National organization and international organizations. And next is from the reports and rankings, right? So can I say these are mostly data and facts only, right? And overall concept is still dominating. 70% questions will come from concept, 30% questions will come from these areas: data facts, government schemes, organizations, reports and rankings, right? Now please see this question. Definition based question, right? This is a question of which year? Which UPSC examination? This question. 2021. Yes, 21. Very good. In India, the current the central banks function as the lender of last resort, usually refers to which of the following? Okay, so this is the, you know, function of central bank. The question is easy. Okay, lender of last resort, this is a very very popular term. I still remember in my 10th class I knew this word because I was from commerce background. I'm not comparing you with me, but this is a very very popular word. But sometimes we don't understand what is the meaning of last resort. To whom? So always ask a question. To whom? Especially this is a, you know, phrase, lender of last resort. This is a very very popular word. In newspaper you will come across this. In your standard books you will come across this. In your material notes you will come across this. So what is the answer in this question? The answer is basically B. Okay, B, two only, right? Basically, if you see, there are multiple functions of the central bank. One category of function is as a regulator. Then we have the functions bank of the government. Then we have the function of, you know, bank of the banks. So this lender of last resort is a function which comes under the category of bank of the banks. So if you know that in the overall category of functions, bank of the bank function, in this category this function is falling, then you can easily decide that this is B. Otherwise you will struggle. Are you getting? So RBI functions, they are in multiple category. Category 1, regulatory. Category 2, bank of the government. Category 3, bank of the bank. And there are some other categories. So if you know this function is from the bank of the bank, this function is played done as a bank of the bankers function, then you will easily get this. Are you getting, everyone? For how many of you this was a difficult question or a moderate question? Not easy question. I'm bringing you close to the thinking pattern which you should have while you are reading. Because if you know the ultimate goal, the type of questions that are coming, then you can decide, you can keep those things in your mind and you can read accordingly. Otherwise you will struggle. Most of the people are saying moderate. Okay, I understand. So most of the people, it is easy, moderate and difficult, right? Some of you, for you it is easy, right? Next question, the definition based question. Again, this is a question of which year? 2020. Gold trench, reserve trench refers to this is one statement based question, right? Now even if you are not clear, very much clear about the statement, but if you can read, I mean you can again solve this question if you have gone through the syllabus very detailed, right? So reserve trench, the answer is option D, credit system by the IMF to its members, right? This is basically part of what? Gold trench is part of what? It's one of the component of anyone?
Bailout.
Yeah, SDR, obviously, yes. SDR is part of what? Foreign exchange reserves. So as a part of foreign exchange reserve, we read SDR and then we also read gold trench. So bit of deep question, I will say. I mean the question is not that they are not asking very deep meaning of the question is not difficult, but if you know where did you learn this concept, exactly aapne kahan pe padha tha, kiska component hai, then you can solve this, right? You asking something?
There are foreign reserves with RBI, and this gold trench is different from that. No?
This is included as part of the foreign exchange. This
Of RBI.
Yes. Okay. Now the next question is again very conceptual question. Very conceptual question, right? 2021. With reference to Indian economy, demand pull inflation can be caused or increased by which of the following? Basically,
B.
See, in this question, if you can eliminate statement number 5. Statement 5 is
wrong.
Incorrect.
1, 2, 3, 4 are right.
So if statement 5 is incorrect, then option B, C and D are wrong. So answer is A. Right? Answer is A. If you are a beginner, don't worry. This is the concept. And if you read this concept in a systematic manner, then you can do this. Because rising interest rate, it will never increase inflation. It will decrease inflation. Because rising interest rate will make the borrowing costly. People will borrow less amount. If they borrow less amount, then what will happen?
Purchasing power will decrease.
Their purchasing power will decrease. So they will demand less goods. If they demand less goods, then demand pull inflation will go down. It will not increase. So if you know that this statement number 5 is wrong, then this is actually elimination based question. Most of you will get stuck where inflation index, I mean you know ki haan theek hai, 1 bhi theek hai, right, 2 bhi theek hai, 4 bhi theek hai, but many of you will stuck here. इन्फ्लेशन इंडेक्स इन वेजेस, ये क्या है? पहली बात तो मीनिंग पता नहीं है. आई मीन टू मैनी ऑफ यू इंडेक्सिंग जैसे वर्ड आया, ऑल्दो दिस इज वेरी सिंपल वर्ड. इन्फ्लेशन इंडेक्सिंग वेजेस मीन्स व्हेन वेजेस इंक्रीजिंग इन कोरस्पोंडेंस टू द इन्फ्लेशन रेट. इफ इन्फ्लेशन इज इंक्रीजिंग बाई 10%, वेजेस ऑल्सो इंक्रीज बाई 10%. इफ यू सी इन गवर्नमेंट देर इज ए टर्म, गवर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉयज के लिए देर इज ए टर्म, क्या बोलते हैं उसको, डीएनएस अलावेंस, डी ए, राइट? So DNS allowance, that is only, that is nothing but the inflation indexing of the salary. इन्फ्लेशन से हमने उसको लिंक कर दिया, इन्फ्लेशन से हमने उसको जोड़ दिया. इफ देर विल बी इंक्रीज इन द प्राइसेस देन सैलरी विल ऑल्सो इंक्रीज, राइट. सो दिस इज द, दिस इज द क्वेश्चन हियर, राइट. नाउ बेसिकली इन्फ्लेशन इंडेक्सिंग वेजेस, दिस इज द कॉन्सिक्वेंस ऑफ द डिमांड पुल इन्फ्लेशन. दिस इज द कॉन्सिक्वेंस. Are you getting? So you have to clearly understand the cause and the impact differently, right? This question, I think this is 2018 question. Conceptual question again. Capital adequacy ratio is the amount that banks have to maintain in the form of their own funds to offset any loss that banks incur if the account holders fail to repay dues. Okay. CAR is decided by each individual bank. Which statement is correct here?
At least one is correct.
Okay, anyways, my purpose here is not to discuss this, otherwise we will miss out certain important things. I'll be moving a bit faster here, right? So I'm just showing you the different category of questions which are coming, right? This is the conceptual questions. Then coming to the data and facts. Most of the India's external debt is owed by government entities. Most. This is a basically trend or a pattern. Mostly they are not asking the fact. They are asking the pattern or trend. So if you are aware from the economic survey, every year this economic survey will come. एक्सटर्नल डेट गवर्नमेंट का ज्यादा नहीं है, 80% इज नॉन गवर्नमेंट, 20% इज गवर्नमेंट. वी आर वेरी वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग, आवर रेटिंग इज वेरी वेरी गुड बिकॉज आवर गवर्नमेंट इज नॉट बोरोइंग मच अमाउंट, राइट. ऑल ऑफ इंडियाज एक्सटर्नल डेट इज डेनोमिनेटेड इन द यूएस डॉलर्स. ऑल नहीं हो सकता. दिस इफ यू सी एनी एक्सट्रीम स्टेटमेंट प्लीज बी वेरी वेरी केयरफुल अनलेस यू आर 100% श्योर दैट दिस इज करेक्ट. Mostly it will be incorrect. So all, the word all, this is extreme word. जब भी extreme word देखेंगे तो क्या होगा, लक्ष्मण रेखा cross नहीं करना है. Only and only if you are sure कि मैं राम हूं, मुझे आता है, right? Only and only if you are sure that I am Ram or Lakshman, I can tackle the Ravan, even Lakshman can't. Then only you can cross. Otherwise, don't cross your Lakshman Rekha. Mark this wrong. Only and only if you know that 100% this is correct statement. You are 100% sure. Then only you should mark it correct. Otherwise, wrong. Right? Government schemes. Direct questions. If I say at the core, this is not economy, this is governance. Right, but many people include in economy, so I'm also including here. Right, so this question is direct question. This type of question they will ask. They have repeatedly been asking these questions. International organizations, again, this is at the core. This is not economy question. This is IR question. Factual question, right? Now, if here also, if you see largest, extreme word, any extreme word, any, all, never, always, increasing, always decreasing, these are extreme words, wrong. All these are previous year questions. And you can see, jahan par bhi extreme words are, mostly wrong hai. 99% they will be wrong, right? This is one of the national organization. Or recently हमने RBI के question देखा, that was also national organization. Or they can ask the question from suppose any committee, any this suppose monetary policy committee, those are all organizations, right? Reports at the court, this is not the question of question of economy, this is IR basically, but overlap karta hai na, difficult to define boundaries, right? So you can say anything, but question to UPSC mein to hai. Coming back, I discussed glancing previous year questions. For how many of you it was something new, like you learned something or you got some clarity so far when you saw the previous year questions? You got some clarity. Okay, wonderful. Simran, Nazmul, very good. Now the second part we'll be discussing is building foundation, how to go about it. Three books you can follow. Indian Economic Development, very very important for the mains examination, very very important, I will say. Even for the prelims it can help, but very very important for the mains. Microeconomy, only selected chapters, and this is important for the prelims. NCERT ka to ye ho gaya. Now if you ask me one book, which book I will suggest is Indian Economy by Nitin Singhania. Many of you are not aware about this book, but this is a wonderful book, 100% exam oriented, no extra content, all the good content is given here, very very exam oriented, right? There are other books also. Suppose you want to get a clarity about concept only, so Shankar Ganesh, but again it is not covering all the things. Other books are incomplete, I will say, not complete one. There are notes of a famous institute, very very popular, the notes, but again if we see the present trend, the latest trend, this book is very very, because this book is a new book in the market, only 2 years ago it came. So they actually make this author is actually making this book exam oriented, completely on the new pattern, not on the outdated pattern, right? Now prioritization of topic is something which is very very important. Even in the fundamental I told you, focus on 6 chapters and listing down 60 topics. So 50 ko 60 kar lete hain, 6 and 60 का अप्रोच लाते हैं. 60 टॉपिक की लिस्ट आई विल फाइंड एंड आई विल पोस्ट इट फॉर यू. ओके, चैप्टर वाइज. वल्लभ, आई डोंट नो अबाउट हिज बुक मच, यू हैव टू चेक वेदर इट इज कंप्लीट और नॉट. ओके, देर आर मैनी रिपीटेड थीम्स, यू हैव टू फोकस ऑन द रिपीटेड थीम्स. रिपीटेड थीम्स में फॉर एग्जाम्पल FDI, FII, वॉट इज अदर रिपीटेड थीम, सपोज मनी सप्लाई, द क्वेश्चन लाइक मनी मल्टीप्लायर और लिक्विडिटी सिस्टम्स, राइट? देन मॉनिटरी पॉलिसी टूल्स. सो 60 टॉपिक्स में दीज आर द एरियाज which they are focusing and repeating year after year, right? So now coming to, we have discussed previous year question, which books to cover. Now if you are already covering some book, don't change the book, but just find whether you are covering the 60 topic that we will be giving to you in a very very systematic manner, right? Next is application of concept, this is very very important. Current affairs mein application of concept you have to do in a very very systematic manner. There are so many sources of current affairs. Yojana only mains ke liye hai, Kurukshetra mains ke liye hai, economic survey I will tell, Indian Express mein there are some, in Hindu and Indian Express mein there can be some boxes mein wo they can give some terms or they can give some data, so you can have an overview about the boxes. Indian Express में explained section में sometime they go into the details of any term, so you can हाँ तो इन एक्सप्लेन सेक्शन में दे कैन डू दिस राइट. बजट आई विल टेल यू, इंडियन इंडियन ईयरबुक आई विल टेल यू वेरी सून हाउ टू गो अबाउट इट. ओके इकोनॉमिक सर्वे, देर आर हाउ मेनी वॉल्यूम्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिक सर्वे? टू वॉल्यूम्स राइट. वॉल्यूम वन इज मोस्टली अबाउट एनालिसिस पार्ट, रिकमेंडेशंस. सो दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर प्रीलिम्स और मेंस? मेंस. फॉर प्रीलिम्स यू कैन इग्नोर दिस कंप्लीटली, कोई फायदा नहीं है पढ़ने का प्रीलिम्स के लिए. ओके वॉल्यूम टू इट इज कवरिंग द कोर एरियाज लाइक नेशनल इनकम, मनी एंड बैंकिंग, पब्लिक फाइनेंस, ऑल ऑफ दिस. सो दिस इज फॉर द प्रीलिम्स. आउट ऑफ दिस वॉल्यूम टू ऑल्सो नो नीड टू रीड ईच एंड एवरीथिंग, देर आर ओनली इंपॉर्टेंट बॉक्सेस, सम न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट इन केस देर इज सम न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट, ट्रेंड्स दे विल आस्क फ्रॉम हियर. एंड अगेन दिस बॉक्सेस मैक्सिमम देर आर 10-15 बॉक्सेस विच आर इंपॉर्टेंट लाइक composition of Indian export, composition of Indian import, like the trading partners of India. Then there is a box about deficits, current account deficit, trade deficit and all, public deficit like fiscal deficit, current account deficit. So you know those boxes are really important. Okay, so volume 2 is for the prelims. Mains mein, yes, maybe in agriculture, in infrastructure, in industry, few data you can pick up from here. In Mains Maximizer Masterclass, I tell you about the value addition part that you can do, right? Value addition aap kar sakte hain. So only that much is important from the volume 2 for the mains. Otherwise, mostly it is for the prelims. So please don't cover the volume 1 for the prelims. And don't ignore the volume 2. When prelims, when this volume 2 will come, I will discuss again. I will discuss and we will discuss the important concept, right? Along with the economic survey, please go through the basic concept. Budget. In budget, again, no need to cover end to end, word by word. The new government scheme you can cover. Because budget is a opportunity. This year budget will bring a lot of new schemes. Why?
Elections
are in Punjab and UP mein, right? UP is the road to Delhi. So is that bahut saari government scheme aane wali hain, be ready for that. But exam mein usme se mostly nahi aayengi, because in the examination they are asking which government schemes, the popular ones or successful ones. You will find the question from, say, MG Narega, Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana. Jo successful government schemes hai, wahan se questions aate hain. No need to cover each and every, you know, scheme. Utna darne ki zarurat nahi hai. What other area, what other thing you have to focus? Again, trends. Jo budget mein trends diye gaye hain, comparisons diye gaye hain. Ki current year mein inflation 5 years में बढ़ा है कि घटा है, ठीक है? डेफिसिट के बारे में, डेफिसिट फाइनेंसिंग के बारे में, राइट? ट्रेंड कंपैरिजन यू कैन डू, राइट? एंड आई थिंक दीज टू थिंग्स आर सफिशियंट. इफ यू डू दिस, दिस इज सफिशियंट फॉर यू. इंडिया ईयर बुक, एवरी ईयर दिस बुक कम्स एंड दिस इज द मोस्ट बोरिंग बुक ऑफ द एंटायर यूपीएससी. In case you have gone through this, please don't buy this book. What you can do at the most is the crux or the synopsis of these chapters only. Basic economic data, commerce, agriculture, energy. Basically, mostly they are asking, they are giving the static portion here. Mostly they are giving the static portion here. So we are back step by step approach mein. Previous questions we have seen how to cover the basics, NCERT and some standard book. Third is application of concept, current affairs. I told you how to cover economic survey, how to cover budget, how to cover India Yearbook, right, and rest of the newspaper and all, right. Revision is very very important. Okay, so revision ke liye what you should do is, number one, make revision register where you will be making a summary of the 60 concept, the processes, right, synopsis banayenge aap log, theek hai. This is one thing that you should do for the revision. And what else you can do, you can make some audio clips, jo bataya tha maine aapko earlier also, I am telling you multiple times, revision clip you can make, right. You can make some mind maps to make it more clear for you. You can interlink and you know, make some interlinkage diagram for yourself, like what is the linking between inflation and repo rate. So as much as possible, make it clear for yourself by making the crux notes, summary notes, right. We are providing crux notes, summary notes, very very popular, bahut sare log jante hain aap logo mein se. So only 90 pages, I think 93 pages, I have covered entire economy, the core areas, the static portion through the crux notes. So you can also refer to that. Okay, otherwise for yourself you should make your own notes, especially for the 60 concept that I'm telling, 6 chapter, 60 concept, make your own notes after understanding, after going through. Okay, next is MCQ and PYQ practice. Now this is again very important. For MCQ and PYQ practice, first, practice NCERT based questions. Not all the NCERT, but 11th and 12th NCERT, right? So 11th and 12th NCERT, 11th mein Indian Economic Development, 12th mein Macroeconomy. Is pe based questions hote hain, you can practice, okay? In our economic course, we will provide this. Topic wise conceptual MCQs. Topic wise, like money and banking, external sector, टॉपिक वाइज कॉन्सेप्चुअल एमसीक्यू प्रैक्टिस कीजिए आप. ओके, पीवाईक्यू तो वो तो करना ही है. देन वी हैव करंट अफेयर्स बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस, फुल लेंथ मॉक टेस्ट. सो दीज आर द 5 लेवल ऑफ क्वेश्चंस दैट यू शुड प्रैक्टिस. ओके, नाउ सम ऑफ द प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन वी कैन सोल्व विद द हेल्प ऑफ सम बेसिक हैक्स, सम एमसीक्यू सॉल्विंग टेक्निक्स. Some observations I will tell you. Are you interested in that? Okay. So this is the first one. Read the question carefully. Now, in this question, there is a turning word which can change the meaning of the entire answer. I mean, which can change the answer. What is that word?
Necessary.
Okay. Online, what is that word which can change the entire meaning of the, which can change the entire answer basically? Yes. It is necessarily. Okay. Because necessarily, if it is necessarily, then we have to look into the definite statement. Ki definitely aisa hona chahiye. The effect of devaluation of a currency is that it necessarily improves the competitiveness. Theek hai, ye to theek hai. Then ye to, this is wrong. Okay. Improves the trade balance. Now, necessarily improving the trade balance is not sure, because trade, what is the meaning of trade here? Goods ka import and export ka balance. So this is trade balance. So devaluation can increase the export, but we don't know about the import. So necessarily word can change the meaning. So you have to really be very very careful whenever you see this type of question. Please mark the word which can change the entire answer. Okay, then solve the question, right? So you have to be very very careful about reading the question. This is a question of which year?
21.
How many of you really made a mistake in the examination 2021 mein? Kitne logon ne galat kar diya tha? How many of you made a mistake in 2021 examination in this question? Anyone online? if you appeared in 2021, okay, Simran made a mistake, Gargi made a mistake, okay, Khushbu, okay, you didn't make a mistake, very good. Okay, Gaurav, you made a mistake. Sahil, okay, you did not make a mistake. Okay, so there are many people basically, right? Again, this is the question. In this question, this word not, many people will skip. यहाँ पर तो मैंने highlight कर दिया है, but this word not will actually change the entire question. If the RBI decides to adopt an expansionist monetary policy, which of the following would it not do? So this word not I have highlighted, but many of you will not read this carefully. The moment you come across any unusual word, please make a mark over that. प्लीज उसको गंदा कर दीजिए एकदम, ताकि वो दिखता रहे साफ साफ आपको, राइट? नेक्स्ट, इन द डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो, विच ऑफ द ईयर, विच ईयर दिस क्वेश्चन इज फ्रॉम, डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन है ये आपका, बट इन द डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो ईच एंड एवरी वर्ड इज इंपॉर्टेंट. दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन ऑफ 2020. Most of the questions that I have picked up from are from the last 2 years, right? So 2020 question here, certificate of deposit is a long-term instrument issued by the RBI. This is wrong. Reserve Bank isko issue nahi karta. Kaun issue karta hai isko? Huh? Certificate of deposit. Who issues the certificate of deposit?
SEBI.
Okay. सेबी तो नहीं करता है, कौन करता है? कमर्शियल बैंक करते हैं, राइट? डिपॉजिट कौन लेता है? बैंक्स लेते हैं, सिंपल. हियर जीरो कूपन बॉन्ड आर इंटरेस्ट बियरिंग. ये इंटरेस्ट बियरिंग होता ही नहीं है. इफ यू नो जीरो कूपन बॉन्ड, दे आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज व्हाट इज द ऑल्टरनेटिव नेम? What is the alternative name? What is the alternative name of the zero coupon bond? Deep discount bonds. Hai na? So actually at the time of issue only, the discount is given at the issue price and redemption is done at par price. Redemption is pe par pe hota hai, face value pe hota hai. That is why they are not giving any separate interest. Zero coupon ka matlab hi coupon, what is the one meaning of the word coupon here? Coupon ka matlab hi interest hota hai. So the name itself says ki zero interest hai. So interest bearing to ho hi nahi sakte. राइट, इंटरेस्ट बेयरिंग तो हो ही नहीं सकते. द वर्ड कूपन हियर इज इंटरेस्ट, सो जीरो इंटरेस्ट है, तो हाउ कैन बी दे बी इंटरेस्ट बेयरिंग? सो यू हैव टू बी वेरी वेरी केयरफुल व्हेन यू रीड द स्टेटमेंट. क्लियर एवरीवन? सो आंसर इज हियर सी 1 and 3. बी केयरफुल ऑफ एक्सट्रीम वर्ड्स लाइक नेवर, ऑलवेज, नॉट, स्टेडली, ऑल, अनलिमिटेड, और क्या वर्ड हो सकते हैं? एनी, एवरी टाइम, हाँ ये भी हो सकता है, ऑलवेज, मोस्टली. मोस्टली मे, आई मीन मोस्टली इज नॉट एन एक्सट्रीम वर्ड, बट हाँ यू हैव टू लुक इनटू द स्टेटमेंट एक्चुअली. बट ऑलवेज, नॉट, स्टेडली, नेवर, ऑल, अनलिमिटेड, एनी, दीज वर्ड आर लक्ष्मण रेखा, ठीक है? So here in these two statement, in case of all cereals, pulses and oil seeds, the procurement of MSP is unlimited. So two word aa gaye yahan pe, all and unlimited. Unless you have, yes, only bhi ho sakta hai. Yes, Rahul, very good. Only bhi ho sakta hai. Stat bhi to likha hua hai na? Second statement, in the case of cereals and pulses, the MSP is fixed in any state or UT at the level to which the market price will never rise. Unless, huh? Yeah, sorry for the interruption. So this is again trend. Extreme words mein. Now this question. Some of you who are asking you how to remember the facts. Basically, for the facts, there are some important facts. You have to develop your meta memory about those facts. For example, is India's exports of goods is more or import is more? Means goods mein export jyada hai ki import jyada hai? Comparison between import of goods and export of goods. Right? Comparison between import of goods, import of services. Comparison between import of services, import of export of services. Comparison between trade relation with China versus Bangladesh, with Bangladesh versus Nepal. These are some fundamental things. Like, what is the major source of deficit financing for Indian government? Is Indian government the largest borrower or the private sector? Is India's debt long term or short term primarily? Are you getting? So there are some very simple and very important concept which you should keep in mind. If you know them, you can solve most of the questions with the help of latent memory, meta memory, and some latent interlinkages. Like this question: the value of Indo-Sri Lanka trade has consistently increased in the last decade. 10 saal consistently increasing seems very extreme statement. Extreme word yahan par use kar sakte ho aap log, right? Textile and textile articles constitute an important item of the trade between India and Bangladesh. If you know, Bangladesh is very good in textiles. If you know this point, if you have read geography in a very good manner, if you know what is the strength of Bangladesh, then you will understand, yes, this can be true, right? Because out of thin, at least one should be true here. Third, in the last 5 years, Nepal has been the largest trading partner in South Asia. Nepal, the relations with the Nepal have been very bitter. Theek hai? Not very good. So trade relations are down hue hain actually. Right? So Nepal to nahi hai. Seems difficult. South Asia mein, we have another good partner, Bangladesh. Bangladesh hamesha hamara acha partner raha hai. So here 1 and 3 wrong. Are you getting? So iske liye aapko koi fact such, you don't have to read any fact, but yeah, by reading, you know, maybe regular news or developing your concept for a long time, you can solve this type of question, right? Ab iske liye aapko, you know, economic survey bahut zyada padhne ki zarurat nahi hai, right? This can appear sometime in news or like that only. Elimination based question. Here, the second statement, certain provisions in the Constitution of India gives the central government the right to issue directions to the RBI in the public interest. Ab ye bataiye ki central government RBI kiske kaise bana hua hai? RBI is under a act. RBI is a statutory authority. What is the meaning of statutory authority?
Formed by an act,
right? ये एक्ट में बना हुआ है. Now, क्या एक्ट में बनी हुई कोई चीज के लिए कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन में प्रोविजन करना पड़ेगा? आरबीआई एक्ट, आरबीआई इज अंडर एन एक्ट. क्यों? कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन विल गिव एन इंस्ट्रक्शन कि सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट उस एक्ट में जो बॉडी बनी हुई है उसको करेगा. कॉन्सेप्चुअली दिस इज वेरी रॉन्ग. इफ यू एलिमिनेट दिस, देन A you can eliminate, B you can eliminate, D you can eliminate. Now 1 and 3 पढ़ लीजिए एक बार. हाँ, 1 लगता है, हाँ, appointment central government से होती है. You can correlate कि जब government change होता है तो RBI government भी change हो जाता है mostly, और वो खुद से resign कर देता है. Means you can latent memory use कर सकते हैं. If you don't exactly remember, you know, now some of you will stuck कि सर मुझे तो पता ही नहीं है कौन appoint कर सकता है. You know, latent memory लगाइए ना कुछ. गवर्नमेंट चेंज, सो आरबी गवर्नर चेंजेस. मोस्टली यू विल फाइंड दिस ट्रेंड. जैसे जब मोदी जी आए थे तो कौन चला गया था छोड़ के?
रघुराम
राजन छोड़ के चले गए थे. बाद में उर्जित पटेल भी चले गए. डिफरेंस ऑफ ओपिनियन की वजह से, राइट. गवर्नर ऑफ आरबीआई ड्रॉज हिज पावर फ्रॉम आरबीआई. यस, दिस इज एन स्टैट्यूटरी बॉडी, सो दिस इज वेरी नेचुरल. सो अनलेस यू फाइंड समथिंग कंट्रारी, दिस स्टेटमेंट विल बी करेक्ट. कैन वी सोल्व विद द हेल्प ऑफ लेटेंट कॉन्सेप्ट, विद द हेल्प ऑफ सम कॉन्सेप्चुअल बेस? दिस क्वेश्चन, देर आर मैनी क्वेश्चंस विच यू कैन टेक ऑन योर ईगो और यू कैन लीव, द चॉइस इज योर्स. ईगो पे लेंगे तो यूपीएससी को पसंद नहीं आएगा, आपको फेल कर देगा. सो नेवर ब्रिंग योर ईगो, स्पेशली द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ योर चॉइस. सपोज यू आर वेरी गुड इन ज्योग्राफी, मिस्टेक्स आप कहां पे करते हो? टेल मी विच सब्जेक्ट यू डू द मोस्ट मिस्टेक. इन योर फेवरेट सब्जेक्ट यू विल डू द बिगेस्ट मिस्टेक. सिली मिस्टेक जो होती है ना, कहां पे होती है? इन योर फेवरेट सब्जेक्ट. द सब्जेक्ट विच इज डिफिकल्ट फॉर यू, यू विल नॉट अटेम्प्ट द क्वेश्चन इटसेल्फ, यू विल लीव द क्वेश्चन. बट अगर आपको पता है कि मेरी इकोनॉमी अच्छी है तो आप जानबूझ के ये क्वेश्चन तो कैसे छोड़ सकता हूं मैं, इज्जत का सवाल है, राइट. सो नेवर मेक एनी क्वेश्चन योर इज्जत का सवाल. देर इज नो इज्जत, द ओनली इज्जत इज प्रीलिम्स क्लियर करना है. सो बी वाइज, राइट. डोंट अटेम्प्ट द क्वेश्चन, राइट. नाउ इट इज द नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, द नंबर ऑफ आंसर विच आर रॉन्ग इज इंक्रीजिंग. सो इट इज वाइज टू अटेम्प्ट लेस नंबर ऑफ क्वेश्चंस, राइट. हियर क्वेश्चन, सी क्वेश्चन सॉल्व हो सकता है, क्वेश्चन सॉल्व हो सकता है, बट आजकल तो क्वेश्चंस भी ऐसे आने लगे हैं कि यूपीएससी भी ऑप्शन विड्रॉ कर लेता है, आई मीन यूपीएससी भी अपने एवेल्युएशन में उसको हटा देता है, यूपीएससी भी गलत क्वेश्चन बना देता है कई बार, है ना. तो आई एम नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस क्वेश्चन, बेसिकली आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट द मिस्टेक विच कैन हैपन विद द यूपीएससी. अगेन दिस इज अ डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन, एक चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट भी कंफ्यूज हो सकता है इसमें. दिस इज अ क्वेश्चन ऑफ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंसी लेवल, हमारा इन सी ए इन द फाइनल ईयर और इन द इंटरमीडिएट ऑल्सो वी कम अक्रॉस दिस वर्ड इंटरेस्ट कवरेज रेशियो. यू कैन कम अक्रॉस इन योर न्यूज पेपर ऑल्सो, बट यू रेयरली गो थ्रू द डिटेल्स. आई मीन इवन इफ यू गो थ्रू द डिटेल्स यू विल नॉट अंडरस्टैंड, आप क्रैम करके जाओगे एग्जाम में. डिफिकल्ट होता है, कुछ क्वेश्चन डिफिकल्ट होते हैं, राइट. सो इफ यू आर गुड देन इट इज ओके, अदरवाइज लीव. दिस इज अगेन डिफिकल्ट क्वेश्चन. Right? Difficult question. Means I'm not saying you have to leave, but don't take on ego. If you're not clear, please move. Don't stuck. And if after spending 1 minute you can't eliminate a single option, then move to the next question. You should have upper limit of 1 minute to spend on one question. उसको आगे बढ़ जाइए, move कर जाइए. Don't stuck yourself, है ना?
Sir, one thing which I mark in difficult questions, if UPSC doesn't want us to do that, there are no ends and means by which we can exclude also.
Actually, हाँ, वो मैं कह रहा हूँ ना, if you can't eliminate a single option in the 1 minute, इसका मतलब आपके लिए question है ही नहीं, छोड़ दीजिए उसको, right? Simple. 1 minute is the upper limit. क्यों 100 questions हैं यार? 100 question में एक question में 1 minute लगा दिया तो आपको वैसे ही 1 मिनट से आज आपको डिजर्व भी नहीं करता. यू कैन 20 मिनट्स यू कैन यूज फॉर द ओएमआर मार्किंग, यू कैन यूज फॉर यू नो रीडिंग द क्वेश्चन. तो 20 मिनट तो आपके ऐसे निकल जाते हैं, तो 1 मिनट तो आपका अपर लिमिट होना चाहिए, राइट. इंटेलिजेंट गैसिंग यू कैन डू. फॉर एग्जाम्पल दिस क्वेश्चन, इफ यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ द वर्ड ट्रेड, ट्रेड इज अ वर्ड विच इज रेफर्ड टू, विच इज विद रिस्पेक्ट टू गुड्स, नॉट सर्विसेज, right? So trade balance, if you know the meaning of word trade balance, this word trade balance is with respect to goods import and export, not services. If you know this, then you read this, like you are not sure about the first statement, suppose. So you can, they apply to investment measures related to trade in both goods and services. तो यहां पे सर्विसेज ही गलत है यहां पे. सो यू कैन एलिमिनेट स्टेटमेंट नंबर टू. सो ए सॉरी So you can eliminate 1, sorry, 2 and D. A, B and D. So answer is 2 only. Sorry. Correct puch raha hai na ye. Yeah, so answer is C. Because 2 to sab jagah aa gaya aapka. Clear? Elimination based okay question. But elimination can happen only after you understand the basic concept. Elimination is based upon your meta memory, upon your latent memory, upon your concept based. Elimination cannot work in isolation. Clear? So elimination of technique cannot work unless you have the very good concept based. Right? Clear? So I have discussed reading question very carefully. Be careful of extreme words. I have discussed this go to broad option. I did not discuss. I'll discuss sometime else. Must always restrict yourself to direct impact or consequences, elimination techniques, which question to leave, and intelligent guessing. Out of this 3 and
4.
ये मैं कभी और discuss कर दूँगा कभी और किसी hacks में. ठीक है अभी we are already running short quite late and I can say 3:30 तक session था but I hope you are learning something right. Pitfalls and traps, irrelevant data and facts. Suppose Sensex कितना बड़ा, ठीक है, repo rate कितना चल रहा है, क्या काम का है repo rate कितना चल रहा है, does not make any sense to you. Increasing, decreasing, yes, that makes sense. What is the impact of increase, decrease, yes, that makes sense. But what exactly, how much is the percentage of repo rate, do not make any sense. Don't go into the micro data, go into the logic behind the data. The impact, the interlinkage between the trained data, the trends, कि पहले के comparison में कम आ रहा है कि ज़्यादा आ रहा है, focus on that thing, because you are going to make a decision, you are going to be the decision maker, not the clerk. आप किस exam की तैयारी कर रहे हैं? Civil servant, which is going to be the topmost officer, class 1 officer. Decision making is your criteria, so decision making can be done on the basis of some analysis, right? So always analyze the data, make a comparison. जो मैं mains में भी बोलता हूँ, irrelevant concept को नहीं पढ़ना है. Still, the fundamental concept should be the base of your preparation. So many free videos available हैं, please avoid them, right? And don't try to cover multiple books. कि सर economy के लिए मैंने बहुत सारी books खरीद ली हैं, अब तो मेरा economy clear हो जाएगा, कभी clear नहीं होगा, right? And many of you start reading economic times, business standard, right? Especially the beginners, जो beginners होते हैं वो mistake करते हैं या फिर जिनकी economy कमजोर होती है, please do not do that, right? क्या करना चाहिए? Have some patience. UPSC में patience सबसे बड़ा tool है. Practice MCQ test when you are practicing the when you are reading the concept questions. Revise regularly I always prefer. Static concept interlinking with the current affairs, please do that, right? Focus areas I have told you, in national income, money and banking, public finance, external sector, and this is the category A. Ye category A hai mostly. Isme in fact this, you should change this to money market institute, money market. And this is category 2 topics. ये category A है, ये B है. Mains GS, how to prepare? I will discuss in some other session. Especially in the mains, you have to focus on infrastructure. As I have already told you, unemployment, poverty, inclusive growth, syllabus word को आपको focus करना है, right? And yes, if you have a good concept based in prelims, it will help you in the mains also, right? Because if they are asking a question how growth can increase, then you should know what are the growth drivers, factors kya hai growth ke. Then you can write a good answer, organic answer, not a copied answer, right? So what did you learn in the last 1.5 hour? What is the top one learning? I know you have learned so many things, but I am asking only for one learning. The session is not complete. Please stay here. Focus area, okay, very good. Santosh, very good. Focus area, 6 and 60 rule, ho gaya, okay. Important topic list, very good, Simran. Don't be egoistic in taking questions, yes, very good. Elimination technique is based upon the concept.
Concept, it won't work without.
People will teach you elimination se question ho jate hain, but I will teach you elimination do not work unless you have the meta memory, you have the previous year analysis, you have the concept. So that is the base, right? Arthopedia you can refer. Arthopedia you can refer for any reference purpose. Arthopedia is a good website. Investopedia is also good, right? Focusing on words like necessarily, yes. Pre and main economy difference. Very good, Gaurav. Very good. See, if you are feeling confused in any term, if you are feeling difficult in any term, then you can refer to two websites. Investopedia. Or Arthopedia. Investopedia is better. And here also, I mean, in previous years they have asked a question, ETF ka question yahan se aaya tha directly. I think 2018 mein question aaya tha. But not every time. And don't get deep, just take an overview. Theek hai? Otherwise aap log kya ban jaoge? Economics optional ke student ban jaoge. So don't try to research so much. Have a boundary, right? Any doubts, queries? No doubts? Okay.